You know what? I don't like the way you be talking to me, yo. You be yelling and shit. I didn't hear you say that. Dang. What the fuck? You know what? You are hilarious. Hilarious, man. But it's all gravy, though. You know, you don't know no better.
Come here, Corey. I hope you're done. Watch out, that's tired. Hold on, man.
You gotta choose. You like the top or you just like to lose. Make a move. Been at the bottom, I got the proof. You gotta choose. You like the top or you just like to lose. Make a move. Been at the bottom, I got the proof. You gotta choose. Yeah, I jump out the booth. Then I might hop through the roof. Got all the rings, stuff. My team is the truth. But they some lies to you. And they never sing, huh? But they always shoot. And all of their diamonds are new. And that's why I'm here with Villain, cause I really get it. And I need all my honeys in blue. You gotta choose. You like the top or you just like to lose. Make a move. Been at the bottom, I got the proof. You gotta choose. Make a choice. I need 100 pack for my boys. Did be hating and talking and talking and hating. I bet you I kill the noise. I've been a man like I'm painting. I boost up my rating. You know how I play with toys. Pop out on any occasion, get standing ovations. They can't.
The NFL on EA Sports is in the great state of Tennessee at Nissan Stadium here in Nashville. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the Philadelphia Eagles and the Tennessee Titans. Here's the kicker, Jake Elliott, ready to get this one started. And off we go from Nashville. And we will not see a run back on the opening kickoff. This will be a touchback. Second down coming up.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It's only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Here's second and 7 now from the 28. Henry up the middle. And only able to get 2 here. Stopped at the 30.
I think if we put together a job description for a middle linebacker, we would start with being able to hold down things in the middle of the line of scrimmage and be able to take on blockers. But how about the guys who can go sideline to sideline and make plays?
Love a guy that can do that. We saw a perfect example of it right there. Third play here this opening drive as they're up against a 3rd and 5. Trenton Cannon, his first carry of the ball game. And oh, he's just going to be short here, barely. Maybe by a half a foot. It'll be 4th and inches. So opening drive, 3 straight runs, unable to pick up the first.
I know the fans want to see first downs, but guess what? The coaches have reasons for what they're doing. Sometimes they've scripted it, and some of these runs, while they haven't been successful now, they may be successful later on.
They'll run for it with Henry. And this is going to be nowhere close. Needed some inches and ended up losing yardage. A surprising move here on the opening drive of the game. And this defense holds firm here on the opening drive of the night. So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33. In motion right is Brown. Well, 1st down, Sanders not finding a whole lot as he'll get forward for about 3.
I think that's the type of run we'll continue to see throughout this game. The snow coming down, I don't expect a lot of big plays to be broken.
2nd and 6. No, scratch that. 2nd and 7. Another run with Sanders. And he is going to get this close to the first down marker as he's brought down at the Titans 24. A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6.
So much of the game today, we're looking for hybrid players, guys who can do a combination of jobs. And anyone who plays a strong safety position, now more than ever, is a hybrid type player. Half defensive back that covers passes and half linebacker that makes tackles. We just saw the linebacker make that play.
12 yards is the pickup. Good for an Eagle 1st down. If you make the stop there, maybe you hold them to 3 on this opening drive. They didn't get the stop.
Yeah, new set of downs now. Now you're worried about, just as you pointed out, not just giving up 3, possibly giving up 6. Let's see what they decide to do here, because they've got to change up what they have been doing. It hasn't been working.
The man in motion is Brown. A give running left, it's Sanders. And here he'll get it down to the 7. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Hey, when you get good yardage like that on 1st down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
4 yards to go on 2nd down from the 7. Now, Here's a little touch pass as they tap it quickly to their receiver. And he gets halfway there from the 6 to the 3 on a gain of 3.
That's a nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on him before he could get much out of it.
So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. On third down, they'll run it with Sanders. And he's in. Touchdown, Eagles. Miles Sanders, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Eagles will claim the early lead as they're on the board first here tonight. On for the extra point, Jake Elliott. And his kick is no good. An inauspicious start here kicking-wise as this one stays a 6-0 game. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. From the 10. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. Charles, we'll see how this offense responds. Remember the last time they were out, they went for it on fourth down, did not get it, and that led to a touchdown on the other side. So they need a response here.
They certainly do, and I just have a question for you. You think that was a gut feel, or was that analytics that came into play there deciding to go for it on fourth down?
That felt like gut to me. What about you?
Let's go.
Yeah, absolutely, because the way it backfired, where they are in the game, all those things, that didn't feel like an analytics call. That certainly felt like, hey, I feel like we can get this right now. And unfortunately, it didn't work out for them.
And he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of 3. And guess what? It brings up third down.
And I think this is a route we'll see more of as this game goes on, because with his speed, they want to get him the ball in space on drag routes just like this. They want him to get the ball and run after the catch. Good job there, though, holding him for a short gain.
Tannehill. He's got his target, Chris Conley. He's got this to the 30 before being taken down. That goes as a gain of 36 on third down.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So the big play has them all the way down to the 30 now for first and 10. Tannehill going to turn and give this to Henry. And he'll fight forward on the straight ahead running for just a couple of yards, second down.
You've got to be impressed by that defensive front on reps like those. They were not being moved off the line, kept their shoulders square, and gave their teammates time to fight to the ball and limit that gain.
6-0 our score after one. Got it here at the 29 on 2nd and 8. Again, it's Henry. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. 2 runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, quick, quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter.
Here you go. Right here.
They got to get to the 20 to keep the drive alive on third down. Woods, the receiver, in motion right. Now Tannehill. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete.
And he'll be marked down right at the 20-yard line.
Well, they've certainly done a nice job spreading the ball around on this drive. This time he gets it out to his back, and it's another nice play and another first down. They've got the defense on their heels a little bit. They're reacting instead of being aggressive and making plays.
From the red zone now, Tannehill. And that went too far in front. He couldn't reel it in. It's incomplete.
Those throwing windows get a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? And here's the thing. You already probably have 3 points in your hip pocket. You force a throw here and give up an interception, you come away with nothing.
Especially tough in the middle third of the field where he threw that one.
Here we go, here we go.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Woods, the receiver, in motion right. Just beating the play clock now. It's Tannehill. And this is caught at the 8. And the Titans are going to be set up with a first and goal coming up as they get him down at the 6-yard line.
And how nice is it for him to know that when he gets outside the pocket, he's got a reliable tight end he can go to. So he's able to look his way, find his big target, and set up first and goal.
Here you go, here you go.
In motion is Austin Hooper. They'll try to run for it with Henry. And a little bit of space there. Takes it inside the 5 to the 3. Give him 4 on the carry there. It's second and goal.
As long as you've been the air attack that's gotten them down here, but now is where you start to lean on that running game. That's a good pickup there on first and goal.
So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal.
Yo,
back to throw, Tannehill. Got a man, and it's taken in for a Titans touchdown. Jeff Swain from 3 yards out. And the Titans are an extra point away now from moving out in front. Well, that's just how they drew it up, CD. His first read was there, got it to him quickly, and into the end zone.
Absolutely excellent execution by all involved. And the coordinator, yeah, I give him credit, found the perfect play call. The quarterback let it fly as soon as the target came free. And this guy hit a nice catch. Just how you draw it up in practice and then execute it in the game.
Now Bullock will send this one away after the touchdown. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Offense set to begin their next drive.
As this offense comes back out here, Charles, they're trailing in this ball game, and they've been on the sideline for a while. They did score their last time out, but they
rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Andrew Adams, and the Titans are going to take possession of the football. So they try to take the deep shot there, but this defense up to the task.
And a lot of times when you air a ball out like this, if it does get intercepted, there's going to be a lot of space out there to set up a return. And remember, you got 5 big offensive linemen out there playing on their feet in open space. Not a skill most of them possess that allows for extra yardage on the return.
Hey, Henry running right. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 13 yards is the pickup for Tennessee and a first down. After he cleared the line of scrimmage, nice little hole developed.
Yeah, great blocking right there at the start. But how about his vision, finding the open spaces and letting his feet carry him to them?
They keep it with Henry on first down. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
Consecutive positive runs for him on the last two snaps. He certainly appears to be trying to put the offense on his back and just move them down the field when his number is called. The way he's running it, I keep going back to him.
Coming up to the line, and they will need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. 10th carry now for Derrick Henry. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
Nice job there finding room to maneuver, and he worked his way into another first down. And look, they had great field position to start, but boy, they've done a nice job taking advantage of it.
Now they're just hoping to cap it off. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. They'll run it again with Henry. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. 47 yards rushing for him now as he's run it 11 times.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. 4 plays, 3 first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. Now Tannehill. Under pressure, down he goes. Sacked at the 10. That sack courtesy of the effort of Hassan Reddick. First and goal looked like things were set up nicely, and now all of a sudden on second and goal, Charles, a big challenge ahead of them.
And you have to know when you're this close to the goal line, things are going to happen faster, so you've got to get the ball out quick. Not going to have much time in the pocket before the defenders bring pressure.
Second down and goal, Tannehill. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete. Back-to-back great plays defensively. You get the sack on first and goal. A great job in coverage there. All of a sudden, they're looking at third and goal from further back than when they started.
And the really good play callers look ahead and down in distance sequence. Now he's got to backtrack a little bit and go maybe off his play sheet to try and dial something up here.
Big play coming here. It's third and goal. Tannehill. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he will score. Touchdown, Titans. Chigakonkwo from 10 yards out. And the Titans will extend their lead in the final minute of the half. CD, for them, this has just been an offensive explosion here in the second quarter.
Yeah, held scoreless in the first quarter. Now they find the end zone again here in the second. Sometimes you just have to have some patience. A lot of people think it's always an adjustment. You have to change what you're doing. And sometimes you just have to do your game plan just a little bit better. And I think that's part of what we're seeing here.
Will send this one away after the touchdown. This will be returned from deep in the end zone.
And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. Offense set to begin their next drive. A slim deficit here in a one possession game. Not much time left, obviously. We'll see if they can march this down the field, at least get three and take some momentum into the locker room. It'll be Sanders to begin the drive. And an anxious moment or two there, but they do get him down. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number two. Right back to Sanders on first down. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Now another timeout called for by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Second and 10. Throwing is Hurts, eluding the pressure right. That's complete to the former Titan Pro Bowler, A.J. Brown. A first down there on a pickup of 25. I love that play, because in the snow you think run, run, run. Big passing play there.
And defenders hate it, especially in open space, because trying to come under control, break down, and make a tackle in the open field, difficult normal conditions. In these conditions,
here we go.
Almost impossible.
But first down, Hurts. Sanders has it over the middle. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. The Eagles will take their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. Second timeout called for by the defense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. They'll throw on first down with Hurts. And this is caught. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Quez Watkins as the first half is winding down. And the Eagles are able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the first half.
Yeah, touchdown. I love it. Now it's only a two-point game. I know it's the first half, but you've got to think. Go for two. Tie it up. Go into the locker room. What are you doing? Come on.
You're bold. You're bold.
It's real easy to be bold sitting up here rather than down there and making that decision.
We don't have to make those decisions. Either way, little time left on the clock here in the second quarter. We'll see how this all plays out. Throws right side. And he's got it. So they went ahead and went for two to tie the game, and it works out. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. Fields this way up at the 17. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And with 10 seconds left, not really enough time to put something together. They'll indeed try to run it out as they start on the ground. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half.
Block, block. Go.
A handoff, running left, Henry. And the play goes nowhere, losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. Welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. Not too many breaks ahead according to the radar. More snow on the horizon as we are back underway in half number two. And they will not get a chance to return this one. It's through the back of the end zone for a touchback. Offense set to begin their next drive. This offense ready for the first drive of the third quarter. Well, quarters number one and two entertaining. We saw some good offense points put up, Charles, and all tied on the scoreboard.
And it sets us up for what could be a really fun second half, because we've seen both sides score almost at will here in the first half. And now here in the second half, getting the ball first, you've got to think, hey, we can go out and really run our offense the way we did in the first half. But if I'm a defensive player, all I'm thinking is, can I make a play to really help out my team and break this streak of offense?
A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three. They'll go again with Sanders. And the defense closes quickly there. He'll get maybe a yard to the 33.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Dime look defensively here for the Titans on third. Here's Hurts to throw. And this one is incomplete.
How about this defense? They came up with a couple big plays in this sequence, and none better than the one right there, forcing the incompletion and bringing up fourth down.
And now before this fourth and two play comes to fruition, they're going to think about it and call a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
Come on, come on.
They're going on fourth down with Hurts. He's going deep for Brown. And that's caught inside the 35. And he is going to have an Eagles first down as they manage to convert. And that'll keep the drive alive.
Fourth down conversion plays, you usually think 1, 2, 3 yards, maybe 10. Not there. What a huge pickup as the sticks make a drastic shift forward. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Hurts a handoff to Sanders. Might have gotten this one down to the 28, and that's all. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9. And the slot man goes in motion left. Another run here with Sanders. And he'll get this one down to about the 27. Only a yard of the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Now play number 7 of this drive, and it's a tough 3rd and 9. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. And he's going to go down. They get to him back at the 40. The sack by Harold Landry, the former Boston College Eagle.
He's known for his legs and his fancy footwork, but he's not getting much of a chance to use it here. The defense continued to hold the upper hand by bringing him down on that play.
They'll try and throw for it with Hurts. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. The Eagles unable to convert there on 4th. And as a result, it'll be Titan football on the turnover on downs. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. Try and get the run game going. This is Henry. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he will score. Touchdown, Titans.
Bottom line, when you play a runner with these talents, you've got to be able to wrap up and get him on the ground. Or the first person who gets there, hold him up long enough for the next wave to get there and get him down. Otherwise, he will continue downfield and find pay dirt.
Extra point through the snowflakes, up and good. And the lead is now 21-14. Will send this one away after the touchdown. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he'll be brought down right on the chalk of the 20. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They've got some stuff to build on from that last drive because they moved the football, CD, and then they tried to go for it on fourth down, didn't convert, probably left a bitter taste in their mouths.
I would say so, and I think that they go out in this series determined for that not to happen again. In fact, they don't even want to get to a fourth down opportunity. They just want to make sure they get it done within the parameters that they've set for themselves. Run their offense, get it into the end zone. Yeah, I think a little bit of determination and a dash of anger.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Hurts sets up to throw it. A try it for Sanders, but this is intercepted. Picked off by Terrence Mitchell. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. Well, Charles, just some visibly frustrated players and coaches on that sideline right now because those halftime adjustments didn't work. The turnover problems continuing here in the second half, and the defense now sitting pretty comfortably as a result of that pick six.
Hey, that's a great observation too, Brandon, because they did make adjustments at halftime. But how about this other group staying a step ahead despite whatever happened in that other locker room?
And oh, it's blocked. The Eagles have got it. And nothing but green grass here, middle of the field. He's at the 40, the 20. And he takes it the distance across the goal line for 2 points. Boy, at this point, I don't know what's going on down there. You got guys running one way on the pick six, now running the other way to return the blocked extra point.
It's almost like that guy went this way, but the other guy went that way. And guess what? Both of them scored points.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They start on the ground here at Sanders. He'll work his way up the middle for a gain of about four, second down.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. They pick up 4 yards on that carry. So now if you're a play caller, you can do just about anything you want, but on the defensive side of the ball, you scramble a little bit. Now you're behind trying to figure out, do I need to blitz him? Do I need to pressure him? How do I gain an advantage on this snap?
From the 24, Hurts. And that falls to the ground incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up third down.
My first thought is surprise because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. He'll drop to throw. Buying time to his left. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Well, how about the coverage we just saw break out on third down? Dime defense, blanketed the field with extra defensive backs and speed, unable to find an open hole to complete that pass.
They'll try and throw for it here. He's going to look deep for Watkins. And Hurts is intercepted, his third of the game.
picked off by Amani Hooker. And the Titans will take over here just shy of the 30.
Well, you think about it, though, that interception, great for his stats, but bad for field position. It was fourth down.
Yeah, terrific observation. If there is going to be a silver lining, and this is what he'll plead when it comes time to watch it again. Hey, it was just like a punt, right? So we end up taking possession of the ball. But you're exactly right about it. Should have slapped it down. Field position would be better for his offense. But how many times do you get a chance to make an interception that you turn it down? That's when your instinct kicks in and you take the football. In this case, a better decision would have been to knock the ball down.
Here we go, here we go.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. And the busy night for Henry continues.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
The Titans on third down. They've been good, 3 for 4 thus far. They're up against a third and one situation. Here's Tannehill. And this is going to be incomplete.
Coverage is awfully tight there on third down. They actually closed off all the passing lanes, forcing the incompletion and bringing up fourth down.
Swings it out to his running back. So he fought off the tackle, and that effort gives him the first before he's brought down. Just a gain of three, but they'll certainly take it as they convert on fourth down.
I can hear it right now that most people in our business are saying, why aren't they running the football? But I happen to agree with this strategy. They've had success all game long. I don't think they should go away from it. Too often, teams go into that protect mode and end up giving away the football. This team has stayed aggressive and it's working out for them.
And he'll be pretty well stopped in his tracks. Give him a yard up to the 42. The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. And they'll give him another shot here on the ground. And taking it right down Broadway. Touchdown, Titans.
I guess when you look back on it, it was just a matter of time until he popped a big one like that. And, you know, at halftime, you and I discussed it. They had done a nice job on him in the first half. But there were a couple of occasions where it felt like he might wiggle out of traffic and take it to the house. Finally here in the second half, that got done.
Well, look good on the extra point. And the lead is up to 18 now. Now Bullock will send this one away after the touchdown. Well, from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. 79 yards on the ground now for Sanders. He's got a first down. Now they try the right side here. They find some open field here. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45.
That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
Well, that last run makes this a 100-yard night. I've loved the way he's hit the holes. He's been quick, he's been decisive, and he's been a whole lot of fun to watch.
On first and 10, it's Sanders. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and 6.
Nice chunk of yards on first down. It really opens up your options for what you want to do on second. You go right back to him and hope he explodes, or sucker the defense in before throwing over the top.
And this time, not quite to the 30. He'll be down at the 31-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Despite the score, despite the deficit, no quitting this guy. He's running angry, running through arm tackles. He wants to change what that scoreboard is saying.
Alert! Alert!
Another run with Sanders. And he maneuvers up the middle for 3, and it's second down.
Not a huge carry there on first down, but not all of them will be. But still, all in all, a positive play for the offense. It's all about picking up at least a few to set up what you're going to do here on second down.
From the 27, Hurts. And for the 4th time tonight, it's an interception. Picked by Kevin Byard.
Well, time, I mean, certainly not on their side offensively. They had to take some chances, but that interception will further hinder their already slim chance at victory.
Yeah, and you're talking about time not on their side, but it certainly is on the defense's side, and they understood that. They knew they had to press it a little bit, and they planned accordingly. And what a benefit for them, able to pick that one off and hopefully put this game away.
They run on first down, but it only produces a gain of 2. It's second down now. So the Titans in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And no doubt what they're looking to do is just salt away the final couple of minutes and escape with a win. They keep it on the ground. This time it's Henry.
Okay, he didn't break that one all the way, but you got to know that he feels like he's right on the verge, and that's probably exactly what he's telling them in the huddle right now.
3rd and inches, and they've got some extra beef up front. 3 tight ends. They'll try to run for the first with Henry. Oh, he's got a little daylight, and mark him down way up close to the 40 at the 39. That one, 28 yards on the ground.
Well, that is a running back who is not about to go down easily. He fought his way through the contact until the seas opened up for him.
They'll try and chew some clock with Henry. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Didn't get to the sticks, but that's an ideal carry there on first down, isn't it?
I mean, now you're 2nd and 1. Although, you know, in the NFL, even if he picked up the first down, I don't think it's a big difference because the clock doesn't stop.
Yeah, not like college.
Right. If it's college football, you want it. 2nd and 1 is probably better than picking up the first down because in college football, the clock stops with every first down and actually aids the defense in that situation.
A first down carry for Henry. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be 2nd down. Starting to become a tough spot for this defense. You're down 4th quarter, looking a little fatigued maybe on that side of the ball.
Gardner, we've seen this before, haven't we? Because every coach we've ever talked to says body language is important. And now you're seeing guys with their hands on their hips, they're bent over, hands on their knees. And the offensive guys are just saying, let's just keep running it out. We've got them now.
Well, this was a very close ball game at halftime, Charles, but in the second half, that offense kind of kicked things into another gear, and they were able to pull away for the victory.
And, Brandon, I think they're the type of team that just looked in the mirror and said, hey, ton of pressure on, but we're the type of team that can flat out handle it. They stood up with confidence, and made it happen for a victory.